Hey guys, so what we are watching here is basically I'm starting to excavate out this foundation. What has happened is the new pool company, you can see the new pool right there, they had piled all the dirt up against the house, and in a heavy rain, it actually blew out the basement wall. So right now I'm taking away a lot of the dirt to try to get it to be less pressure on the foundation wall. You can watch here that the machine keeps sliding towards the hole, and at this point, I'm trying to squeeze in between basically this nice brand new pool and the house that is on its way on to collapse. So coming down here, you can see I'm just kind of scooping away a lot of the dirt. This has the old tar and plastic waterproofing on the outside. So you see it right there, a lot of it's kind of fallen down. It's not a very effective waterproofing solution, and it actually had failed on this house. So the water was just building up against the foundation wall. So I'm just kind of trying to be careful not to cause any damage to the wall. Starting to dig away here. Down there, you see that there's a little bit of a break in it. It's hard to get all the way down to the bottom of the foundation, but we're doing our best. Pop down here to try to see how we look. And then we're coming around to the inside so you can see how that wall was failing. You see all those cracks along there. The guys are coming in, they're tearing everything down and getting the footing prep. So that's what they just did right there. The footing on this house is fine. What it was is that the block wall itself actually did not have any filled cells. So what that means, you guys see all the holes on the block right there. Whenever they built this house, they didn't put any concrete inside of that. So there was no real rigidity in this wall itself. So as they add these lines, you'll start to see where they're filling the cells. You see some of those holes are filling up there. Took a nice lunch break. And the other thing that we do is what is kind of like a bond beam is just what they're doing right there is they're laying out and they're filling concrete all the way across horizontally as well to make sure that the wall can't move in on either access. So as they're working along here, they're doing a few lines at a time, adding, you know, more concrete, filling those cells as the wall gets built up. So one of the things that I'll note on these walls is, especially here in the Atlanta area, we see a lot of 60s and 70s homes that have complete wall failure. And when they have complete wall failure, you can't repair them with your traditional foundation repair options because it's kind of at a state where it's no longer salvageable. So what has happened is that it is kind of fallen apart. And it's sheared at the bottom, and you just can't really push the wall back or retain the wall at that point because it's disintegrating. So right now they're starting to work on the other side. The reason we didn't tear the whole thing down at once and rebuild it all the way across was because, if you recall from the start of the video, there's a brick facade on the house, and there's nothing to support that brick if we were to remove the wall the whole way across. So they did one section, made sure that rebar and everything's sticking through so they can tie into it on this side. And then here we are on the third day of the wall rebuild, and this is when they are gonna finish up and do our cleanup. So in hindsight, I wish I would have moved the camera over to the other side, but here we are. We're just gonna watch them kind of working through this little window as they're moving across, redoing the scaffolding. It's interesting, this wall is 26 feet long and 9 feet tall. Quite a lot of material ends up coming and going outside of your basement door, or in this case, this was a nice walk-in basement, so it was pretty easy to get access to it. And finishing up on the other side right there, we're gonna start working on cleanup. Thankfully for us, the customer was well aware that, you know, the drywall was already all damaged and everything was already damaged from when the wall had collapsed, and they're gonna be redoing everything. So they told us the floor and everything was gonna get redone. But there you go, you see a nice finished wall, and that's how it's done.